Hey everyone, it's Allison. Welcome back to the Tiny Herd. So it is Vlogmas day 20 or 21. It's Vlogmas day 21. Today I'm going to be giving a couple of the guinea pigs baths and probably doing some nail clipping and just general grooming things. I look like a mess because that's just what happens when I'm just trying to get stuff done. Okay, so this is the grooming bin for all the pets. It says guinea pig on it, but it has bunny stuff in it too. So I just keep their grooming products in here. So what we're gonna be using today is the Posh & Go shampoo from Gorgeous Guineas. So I've talked a little bit about Gorgeous Guineas in the past, but basically they are a company based in the UK that makes basically skincare for guinea pigs. All of their shampoos and products are really, really good for guinea pigs and are formulated specifically to be safe for them. So today we are going to be using, I don't know why it's not wanting to come in focus, but today we are going to be using the Posh & Go since we are bathing my long-haired piggies, and this works really, really well for long-haired piggies because it rinses out really easily. I do also have the Just for Boars shampoo. This one I got to use on Georgie and Johnny just because, I mean, they are boars and this is specifically formulated to be for boars to help prevent skin problems and things like that. So I have those two shampoos. I also do have the Lysin Easy shampoo. I accidentally got these, I mean, I didn't accidentally get them wet, but this got wet and the label rubbed off. But this is a trial size of the Lysin Easy shampoo. I don't ever use this, but I do keep it on hand just in case. I don't really have animals coming in and out of my pet room, but just in case, you never know if someone somehow got lice. I have this on hand just in case. I have, again, this got wet so you can't really read it, but this is the Quench Lotion from Gorgeous Guineas. And this is really for if they have dry skin, any dry patches. I like to put this on ears and stuff in the winter just as it gets drier. So I have this. I also have the Neem Soothe Gel. So this is kind of just like a cooling, soothing, I guess, gel that works good for like if they have a scrape or cut or just like irritation. This can be really good to put on that to kind of soothe the area and make it feel a little bit better. I actually got this for Belle because she tends to not do a good job keeping her like belly and you know, lower area clean because she has a hard time reaching back there as she is a senior piggy. So I got this for her because sometimes she does get a little bit of urine scald. Even just with me regularly cleaning her, she still just has an issue with that. So I did get this as well to kind of help treat that when it does happen. I have other ways that, you know, I like medically treat the problem, but this helps with her comfort. So I have this. And then my absolute favorite Gorgeous Guineas product, this is the Perfect Paws ointment, and they also have an F&M ointment that is very similar. But basically, this is what I put on the guinea pig's paws anytime that I clip their nails. It keeps their foot pads really moisturized, especially because a couple of my pigs just have really dry skin on their feet in the winter, and this works really, really well. Again, it's safe for them, and it's literally my favorite product. I always rebuy this because it just works great to keep their feet in really, really good condition. So those are all of the Gorgeous Guineas products that I have. Again, we're going to be using the Posh & Go today because we'll be bathing my long-haired pigs. I use this on the short-haired pigs as well. It just rinses out super easy, so I just stick with this one. They have a couple other different types of shampoos as well. I will link the company down below. This is what I recommend for grooming your guinea pigs. I don't recommend anything else. It can get a little bit expensive, but this bottle will last us well over a year. They do have expiration dates on them, so keep that in mind, but I highly, highly recommend Gorgeous Guineas products. I rebuy whenever I need to because I have used them ever since I've had guinea pigs, and I just think it is a fabulous company. So that will be linked down below. I'm gonna show you guys how I set up the rest of the bathroom, and we'll get started on these baths. Okay, so for how I set up the bathroom, I have their grooming box over here in case I end up needing anything else out of it, but I always open the shampoo ahead of time because when you have a pig in one hand, it can be hard to get that open with one hand, so I have that ready to go. I always have the towel ready to go because I usually like to set the pig here while I shampoo them, and then I just have the towel ready to go to dry them off when I'm done. I have their a couple brushes. Since I am doing the long-haired pigs, I like to try to brush it out as I wash it. I have nail clippers in case anybody needs nail clips, and then I have a couple pairs of grooming scissors easily accessible, but to where it can't like poke a pig if they're sitting right here, because I know a couple of them are gonna need hair trims as well. So I have that all set up, and then I have my GoPro there so I can get some fun piggy level footage for you guys. So that is my setup. I always try to make sure I have everything ready to go. The one other thing I'm going to do is put a washcloth in the bottom of the sink so that I can give the pig a nice non-slip surface to stand on while they're in there. And I'm gonna go ahead and grab one of the piggies that needs a bath today and get started. All right, so first up, I have Belle Pig here, and she is one of my senior girls. She doesn't actually need a bath. I just want to check her and make sure that her lady bits look all right. And they look pretty good, actually. Yeah, she looks really good. So you can see her belly here. So sometimes she has issues with not keeping herself clean down there. And at one point she was like a little bit balding down there and had some urine scald just because she was dragging her belly and sitting in pee. And at that point I didn't realize that she, you know, I think she has a little bit of arthritis, and as she's getting older, her weight is kind of shifting down to her sides instead of being held so much up in her back. Just that kind of just happens with her shape as she's a older girl. But she has a hard time bending down to clean her lower area, so I try to make sure that I help her keep it clean, and she looks really good right now. All of her fur has grown back that was an issue, and she looks really good. So I'm gonna kind of just, you know, do a little check of her. It looks like her ears are a little bit dry. Her ears are dry, but we'll put some stuff on that right now. And other than that, she looks pretty good. You can tell she's a senior girl. Her eyes are just very droopy now. It's just kind of how she is. But how are you, pretty girl? So I'm gonna put a little bit of this quench lotion on her ears and just rub it on my fingers and rub it on her ears. They're just a little dry. I think it's just from the weather. They're not, I mean, she doesn't have, it's not a major issue. They're just a little dry. So I just don't want them to cause her any issues. So I'll put some stuff on them. You're doing very good. Oh, you're doing very good. Your nails don't look bad either. I just clipped their nails a couple weeks ago, so they look pretty good at this point. All right, you look good. You ready to go back? I'm gonna get that out of your eye. All right, so she's good to go. I just wanted to check her belly. She's looking pretty good, so I'm gonna go ahead and put her back. Alright guys, so I have Junebug here. She is one of my long-haired Texel guinea pigs. She's going to get a bath today and a hair trim. I'm not going to try to talk through it because she is very squirmy and it's going to be hard to do that. So I'm just going to time-lapse this but show you guys what I am doing. We'll be right back. guys, that was all of the piggies that needed baths today. This is the aftermath of our setup. So everybody's done. Nobody was too bad this time. Johnny, no matter what I do, always has one or two little mats in his fur. So we cut those out and he got a bath. Junebug got a bum bath as well. And then we checked on Bell Pig, but that is really all that needed done today. Everybody else is pretty good at this point. So hopefully this gave you guys a good little snapshot of what I do to bathe my piggies. A couple things I did want to mention. First off, I did crank the heat up in our house so that it is a lot warmer in their room than it normally is, just so that nobody gets a cold or catches, you know, a draft or anything like that once they're back in their cage. I also make sure they're pretty dry before I put them back. You guys saw a little bit of that, but I do hold them for a while and make sure that they're pretty dry before they go back in their cage so they're not just, you know, sitting all wet. I towel them off and all of that. So they're back in their cage now. It's a little bit warmer in here so that, you know, they're comfortable. So that is everyone that needed baths. I hope you guys enjoyed getting to see today's little grooming vlog featuring the little babes. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions down in the comments, and I will see you guys tomorrow with another vlog. Bye.